Hi, this is Joachim for statisticsglobe.com, and in this video I'll explain how to add an image on top of a plot in the R programming language. So in the video I'm going to show you an example, and this example is based on the data frame that we can create with lines 2 to 3 of the code. So if you run these lines of code, you will see that at the top right of RStudio a new data frame object appears. And in this example, I'm using the ggplot2 package to draw our data. So for that reason, we also need to install and load the ggplot2 package, as you can see in lines 5 and 6 of the code. I have installed the package already, so I'm just going to load it with line 6 of the code. And after running this line of code, we are able to use the functions of the ggplot2 package. Now, if we want to draw a ggplot2 plot without an image, then we can apply the code that you can see in lines 8 and 9. So if you run these lines of code, you can see that at the top right of RStudio, a new plot object appears, which is called ggp. And we can also draw this plot by running line 10 of the code. And then you can see at the bottom right of RStudio that a new plot is created, which is showing the points of our data in a scatter plot. Now, let's assume that we want to add a PNG file on top of this plot. Then we first have to load a PNG image by using the PNG package. And we can install and load the PNG package, as you can see in lines 12 and 13 of the code. I have already installed the PNG package as well, so I'm just going to load it with line 13 of the code. And then we can use the readPNG function to read an image that we have stored on our computer. So in this example, I'm simply using this image here that you can see on the desktop of my computer. So the image is simply the R programming logo that you can download online. Now, if we want to load this image to RStudio, then we have to specify the path where our image is stored, and we have to specify the native argument to be equal to true. So after running line 15 of the code, you can see that a new data object appears at the top right of RStudio, which is called myImage. And if we want to add this image on top of our ggplot2 plot, we also need to install and load the patchwork package, as you can see in lines 17 and 18 of the code. I have installed this package already, so I'm just going to load it with line 18 of the code. And now we are able to use the insetElement function that is provided by the patchwork package. So if we want to draw our image on top of our plot, then we can use the code that you can see in lines 20 to 25 of the code. So in these lines of code, I'm first specifying the plot that we have created before, which is called ggp. And then I'm adding to this plot the insetElement function. And within the insetElement function, I'm specifying my image. And then I'm also specifying the location of the image where I want to show it in the plot. So after running lines 20 to 25 of the code, you can see that a new plot object appears at the top right, which is called ggpImage. And we can also draw this combined plot to RStudio by running line 26 of the code. And then you can see that our plot is updated. And you can see that on top of our plot, the image that we have loaded before is shown. So in this video, I have shown you how to add a picture on top of a plot in the R programming language by using the ggplot2 package, the PNG package, and the patchwork package. However, in case you want to learn more on this topic, you could check out my homepage, statisticsglobe.com, because on the homepage, I have recently published a tutorial in which I'm explaining the content of this video in some more detail. Furthermore, you could also check out the homepage of the patchwork package, because on this homepage you will find many tutorials on the application of the functions of the patchwork package. And I will put links to my homepage as well as to the homepage of the patchwork package into the description of the video. Furthermore, if you have liked the video, I would be very happy if you leave me some positive feedback in the comments. And make sure to subscribe to my YouTube channel to get notifications in future when I'm releasing new videos to the channel. That's it for this video. Thanks a lot. See you next time.